Hello there, Gamerinos and Gamerinas. Welcome to Unicorn Storm. This is Rady, and today I'm going to tell you about my experiences with the Stranger of Paradise, a Final Fantasy Origin trial version. And with this game, finally, even the Final Fantasy series has gotten its Dark Souls spin-off. Now we have the Dark Souls of Final Fantasy. It's incredible how popular this subgenre has become. I mean, it began with a silly gimmick that in a time where games became easier and easier and were made for mainstream and mass market appeal, that there was this one game that kinda went back to the roots, to the good old arcade and early home console times, where games were brutally hard and borderline unfair, but it earned its difficulty with good level design, with clear enemy attack patterns, and although all the stats and the leveling system was convoluted and overly complicated, it was pretty straightforward when it came to the actual gameplay. You had two attack buttons, as well as a block, a parry, and a dodge button. Pretty much every action consumed stamina, and when you ran out of stamina, you couldn't attack, and even worse, enemies were able to stagger you. But enemies more or less had to abide by the same rules. They had different attacks than you, and they didn't have an actual stamina meter, but they couldn't just spam their attacks, so they had to wait for a few moments after every attack. And you were able to interrupt them by attacking faster, or blocking them, or parry them, which opened them up for a counterattack, which dealt massive damage. And now you had to carefully approach every enemy encounter, keep your wits about you, keep an eye on the environment, and be able to quickly react to whatever might be happening during the combat encounter. Levels were huge and sprawling, full of opportunities to explore off the beaten path, to find special items or shortcuts, and you had to survive a huge number of brutal enemy encounters or traps to reach one of those rare and far between checkpoints. And when you die, you get sent back to the last checkpoint you visited, and all the enemies rise up again, and you even lose all the experience you carried with you, but you get a chance to get it back by besting all the enemies all over again and getting back to the place where you died before. But be careful, if you die again before you recover all your experience, you will lose it forever, which is as exhilarating as it is frustrating. And it worked really well and was hard as balls, and the game was a bit of a niche title. But it was successful enough to spawn a whole franchise, and this franchise got into the mainstream market. And then everyone and their mother wanted to make a Dark Souls clone with their own unique spin. We got a kind of Warcraft Dark Souls, we got Mecha Dark Souls, we got a Dark Souls shooter, we got Onimusha Dark Souls, we even got anime waifu Dark Souls. Well, and now we got Final Fantasy Dark Souls. And it kinda has the basics covered, but in true Final Fantasy fashion, it overcomplicates pretty much everything that wasn't already overcomplicated to begin with. So Stranger of Paradise seems to be kind of a reimagining of the original Final Fantasy I. We play as the Warriors of Light, who were prophesied to fight against and defeat the evil being Chaos. Though, right from the beginning, there's something wrong here. Where is my white mage? We take control of Jack, who's kinda the leader of the Light Warriors, and our two companions are completely AI controlled, and they're about as competent as you'd expect from AI companions. Which isn't the worst thing gameplay wise, because normally a Souls-like tends to be a lonesome single-player dungeon crawler, so I hadn't even expected a whole party. And your companions can sometimes do some decent damage, especially when the enemy is focused on you, and so your companions can do a few critical back attacks, and they can draw the enemy's attention away from you, which can be a blessing when you desperately need to heal, but also a curse when you're charging up an attack and then the enemy just flies into a different direction. But yeah, most of the time they're pretty okay and not too intrusive, but it looks a bit weird when they're just standing around or circling around the enemy without attacking. So I guess it would have been better for my immersion if they just weren't around. The game has a job switching system, so they could have used the party in that way, so that you don't change the class of your main character, but switch to another character who has the class you want to use. But yeah, as I said, this isn't that big of a deal, especially in a Souls-like game, and I'm sure the behavior of your companions will get tweaked before the game gets released. Another more glaring issue they have to work on and tweak is the combat, or more precise, the enemy behavior. So combat in this game is pretty similar to Souls games. You use the right shoulder button for a standard attack and the left shoulder button to block. You also have a special attack mapped to R2 that consumes mana, and your special attacks are dependent on your equipped job and can be a neutral action or a follow-up to a combo, kinda like in Musou games. And you can equip your special attacks to pretty much any position in a combo chain, which is kinda neat. So you can place attacks you want to use early on at the start of a combo chain and have your finishing blows later in the chain so that you can get in a few standard attacks to weaken the enemy before. You also get a sidestep mapped to a face button and a magic shield, which kinda functions as this game's parry attack. And now it gets complicated. So blocking in this game doesn't always prevent all damage. It also empties your break gauge, which is similar to the system in Sekiro. So every time you get hit or block an attack, your break gauge depletes, and when it's empty, you're staggered and the enemy gets a free hit in. But if you're able to deplete the break gauge of an enemy, you can perform a special break finisher, which restores some mana and even increases your maximum mana. Because magic in this game isn't a stat and isn't bound to a class. So it doesn't matter if you're a mage or a fighter, you always start with 2 bars or 200 points of mana. And whenever you use your magic shield to block an attack or kill an enemy with a break finisher, you increase your maximum magic points. And this is important because every time you die, you decrease your maximum magic points. And you need those to perform special attacks, magic, or your, let's call it, limit breaks, where you can activate Lightbringer mode or some other neat enhancements. So you want to exploit enemy weaknesses to faster decrease their break gauge to get a break finisher, or block enemy attacks with your magic shield. But there is a trade-off to using your magic shield. First, you can't just hold down the button. You have to press more or less at the right moment. There is a big enough window to block attacks, but you still have to anticipate the moment where the enemy strikes. But even if you time it well, you still have to be careful when using it, because using the magic shield depletes your break gauge, and blocking an enemy attack depletes it even further. So even though you use your magic shield to block an enemy attack, they can still stagger you and kill you pretty quickly. So you have to constantly way up between using your magic shield to restore mana, but deplete your break gorge or block and deplete your break gorge less, or dodge and deplete nothing, but have a higher risk to get hit by the enemy attack. There is no Dark Souls-like stamina meter in the game, so you can attack and run and dodge to your heart's content, though the animations tend to be a bit slow and you come to a complete stop for a few moments after dodging. So even without a stamina meter, spamming isn't an option. Especially, and now we come to the big problem I have with this game, enemies are quick and they can spam their special abilities. More often than not, they attack faster than you and seem to have no recovery time after an attack, aside from a few attacks that seem to have a sort of recovery period built into the animation. Their attacks also often tend to have a pretty long reach. So it's not uncommon that an enemy kinda jumps back from you and is able to attack you before you get a chance to get a bit closer and start your own attack, even with a longer range weapon like a spear or a greatsword. They also often start their attack after you but finish before you, so they get a lot of cheap hits in and there's not a lot of ways to interrupt them. Sometimes they can be interrupted by using the magic shield, but this doesn't always work. Blocking seems to do nothing, hitting them seems to do nothing, and outside of your sidestep maneuver or the break finisher animation, your character has no invincibility period. And this is a problem in and of itself, but it becomes worse because the enemy placement in this game isn't as, let's call it, fair as it is in Demon Souls or Dark Souls. The game loves to spam a bunch of enemies with ranged attacks or pounce attacks, and when they begin to spam their abilities, the screen just becomes a mess of particles and effects before you die and get sent back to the checkpoint. There was this one hallway that was full of bombers who shot their fireballs or had their fire breath, and pretty much everything was on fire, and it just wasn't fun to get through this. After that, you got access to the mage class and were able to use a water spell to dispose of them faster and with less effort. But well, the encounter still didn't get better from this, just less painful. Enemies also have sometimes unavoidable attacks, and well, I don't like these, and I don't like how they're handled in the game. Sekiro had a similar system in which a kanji symbol appeared above an enemy's head when he was about to perform an unavoidable attack, and then you had to dodge or jump over it to avoid getting hit. This game displays the attack's name with a red background, kinda like in Final Fantasy VII Remake. But often the attack windup is too short to get out of the way in time, especially since a lot of the player's animations are long and slow. As I said, enemies often start their attack after you started yours, and they're still faster and hit you before you have a chance to hit them. So you try to attack them, and since you can't interrupt them, they start their unavoidable attack. And even if you are able to perform a dodge maneuver, often the enemy's reach is so large that they still get you and inflict massive damage. And that's just a bit unfair in a system that's too complicated for its own good. But I wouldn't mind the complicated nature of this combat system if the enemy behavior was more balanced, if unavoidable attacks had a longer windup, if enemies could more often or more reliably be interrupted, and if they had to wait for a kind of cooldown before they can perform another special attack. Because despite all my ranting, I quite like this game, or this trial version of the game. It's kinda neat to have the job system incorporated in such a way, and that you can switch between two equipped classes on the fly, and that certain bonuses you unlocked in one class also affect the other equipped class. So you can buff up a mage by just having a fully upgraded fighter in your second job slot. By mastering a job, you unlock an advanced job. So for the fighter, it's the warrior, for the mage, it's the black mage, and for the lancer, it's the dragoon. You have access to all kinds of iconic Final Fantasy abilities and fight against iconic Final Fantasy monsters. Even the music seems to pay tribute to the original soundtrack. This whole section of the trial version seems to be the first dungeon of the game, where the party is sent forth by the king to rescue the princess. And it works quite well. It doesn't reach the highs of Dark Souls level design, but it's still a neat little dungeon crawler, and I'm excited to see how they will translate the rest of the game into this new format. A lot of people right now are annoyed about how the characters look and about their personality and how this game will fuck up the lore of the original Final Fantasy, but well, I guess we have to wait and see. A lot will change until the game's release, and I'm sure we'll get more insight into the characters and the story. Not that there was too much to begin with in the original. And I'm not saying the original had a bad story, I'm just saying it was a simple story, and maybe that's just perfect for a game like this. My biggest issue is the combat system, and I really hope they address some of the problems I've laid out in this video. Because fuck, that boss fight was a nightmare. There was nothing fun about it, and I hated myself even after beating that fucker. And if the game continues that way, well, just hope it doesn't. But yeah, you can watch and listen to this stuff all day long. So if you're able, try out the trial version for yourself. It won't be available for much longer, which is bullshit. There shouldn't be a time limit on a trial version. But yeah, if you can, try to play it for yourself. And with that, I bid you adieu. Have a great day, and I hope to see you again on the next game.
これで行く。